An award-winning South Australian counselling service for Aboriginal substance abusers has had its federal funding cut. Making Tracks has been at the front line of tackling sniffing, alcohol and drug abuse for 14 years. Program staff believe it's a victim of bad bureaucracy and ill-informed decision-making. South Australian correspondent Karen Ashford reports.
Jimmy Perry and Byron Wright have just returned from what could be their last bush trip to be told they no longer have jobs.
What a waste it is for, like I say, uneducated decisions being made by people who are unaware of what really goes on.
With a master's degree and graduate diploma, they're the most qualified Aboriginal counsellors in the state, with bookings stretching into next year.
At night time we sit around the fireplace and we'll talk about doing education. We've got a generator and a data projector, what we'll set up in the middle of the bush, and we'll throw a DVD on about drug and alcohol, and then we sit around the campfire and workshop it.
Making Tracks not only engages with the rural and the remote communities, but we also engage in Adelaide communities, Adelaide's men's groups, Adelaide's youth groups.
In an average year, they provide frontline services to 3,500 people. They're worried what will happen if their expertise is lost to communities struggling with marijuana, sniffing, crystal meth and alcohol.
We're asked to come back again and again. We know if we weren't doing a good job or they didn't think the service was any good, that we wouldn't be asked to come back. And, you know, over the last 14 years...
The $300,000 program was moved from the Prime Minister's Department to Health on the 1st of July, when suddenly it was scrapped.
They told me that the Minister had said that Making Tracks wasn't a priority, so therefore they weren't providing any more funding, basically as of the 30th of June.
A spokesman for Health Minister Peter Dutton says substance abuse is the responsibility of Assistant Minister Fiona Nash, but her office says funding decisions rest with Mr Dutton. Making Tracks fears it's falling through the bureaucratic cracks.
Either try and get the minister, and we're not 100% sure which minister it is, although Doha did tell me it was Peter Dutton, to sort of try and see whether they can actually relook at that decision.
Making Tracks will plead for emergency funding to honour its bookings and hopes to win a fresh tender in the next round of government contracts at the end of the year. Karen Ashford, NITV News.